Easy.
He's the only one who sees the big picture. Sees the future.
This plan, if this fails, our brothers are going to be gunning for you.
I've never been afraid to swing.
God help us all.
Hey, my name is DeJuan. I'm from Streamwood, Illinois. Second time here in Daytona for the bike week. That bike is gorgeous. The amount of detail that's in the paintwork, you just can't imagine how one person can go over it. The chrome is immaculate. It's a beautiful machine all the way around. And of course, the Harley. It's great to have motorcycle committed lawyers because we need them. Cars cut us off, we go down. It's a great opportunity for us to get to know people like that. That's great.
Chelsea, I am right here in a motorcycle at Daytona Beach, Florida during Bike Week. Make sure you come out, come see us, come out, check out all the custom bikes, see all the lovely ladies, have a good time with us, have fun and ride safe.
Hey, what's up guys? It's Danny from Rubenstein Law. I'm here at Daytona Bike Week 2021. I'm here with X from Providence Cycle Works. X, tell us a little bit about what you do. Tell us about Daytona Bike Week and what it means to you.
I've been honored enough to be next to Rubenstein Law all week, so we've been sharing some space and some laughs. We're here at Daytona Bike Week 2021, the 80th anniversary. Always, always, Daytona Bike Week in March starts off the rally season for the rest of the year. And because of the pandemic, last year we couldn't do this. But today, this week, we're back, man.
Hey, how you doing? This is Arian from Cartel Baggers. We're here live at Destination Harley, signing Rubenstein shirts that we're giving away for free this whole weekend.
At the end of the day, down here at Ross Myers, we're all about the community. That's what life on two wheels represents. And at the end of the day, just coming together as one. And that's what we represent here, not at just the Wall of Death, but at Destination Daytona. We couldn't be more thankful.
My name's Smitty. I'm from Flat Lick, Kentucky. I'm here at the Daytona Bike Week event of the Rasshole Show for 2021. So these things on it, extras, is people is given to me and people I've met and places I've been. So there's things on here around the world.
Thanks for tuning in to Born to Ride TV, the longest running biker TV show in the world. Willie from Willie's Tropical Tattoo was in an accident. He was hit on his motorcycle. We will get an update and we'll also see his awesome chopper show from Bike Week.
This week we're off to Daytona Beach and Biketoberfest, where we head up to Willie's Tropical Tattoo, where Willie's old school chopper show was in full swing with builders and their retro style motorcycles that take you back to a time and place where simplicity, practicality, and uniqueness was what set your machine apart from all others. And that spirit is alive today at this unique old school chopper show. And it's all coming up tonight, right here, only on Born to Ride.
Born to Ride is sponsored in part by Rubenstein Law, 1-800-FL-LEGAL, representing riders since 1988. Offices throughout Florida, 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Instagram is your thing, we're there. We're everywhere. Follow us at hashtag Born to Ride Motorcycle Media, your number one motorcycle resource.
Thanks for tuning in. This week we're off to exotic Daytona Beach, Florida, the Tropical Tattoo and Willie's Old School Chopper Show. This is the real deal with riders and machines that personify the independent biker lifestyle. So stay tuned. All this and much more is headed your way right here only on Born to Ride.
Man, great weather today. Man, you couldn't be more packed in this place now.
That was the biggest one we ever had. And with the economy this bad and stuff, I was surprised this many people showed up. You know, this many people show up, you know, and most of them's friends and stuff, you know, through the years. To have this many people show up at an event like this where we really, I don't know, it's just unbelievable.
What kind of feedback have you been getting over the years since you started it?
Oh, everybody loves it, you know. It's just down-to-earth people, you know, and everybody that shows up here, pretty much they fabricate their own motorcycle parts and stuff and do a lot of their own building from scratch, build these bikes for help. Some of these guys don't put a whole lot of money into them and stuff, and that's what it's all about, being able to put something together on the road without spending a fortune, you know, and that's what this show's all about. Years ago, man, Donnie and Jeff, this whole show started with Donnie and Jeff coming down here and us all hanging out in the parking lot and the lead sled guys, and it just kept growing and growing and growing, and when we started this whole deal, it was just a little fun thing, you know. Now it's turned into a big event.
Like I
probably
said,
the biggest event in Volusia County.
I tell you, people look forward to this. It's real, like you said, man. I want to thank you for always supporting Born to Ride, letting us always be a part of it, too.
Born to Ride.
Really good customers and people that really ride our bikes and really enjoy them.
Tell me about a couple of these bikes you have here.
The newest thing that we brought out our new Sportster platform. It's got the S&S Pro Stock motor in it, and we just kind of showed everybody, you know, how far you can take a Sportster with one of our bikes. It's got our patented spoke wheels on them. It's got all the things that we do best, you know, with our paint, leather work, and our mill work, and lathes. You know, we did all the, turned out all the pegs and controls on them, and put a lot of custom parts for this bike, and it's kind of like, you know, how far you can go if you really want to take it with a Sportster. So that bike's here, and some of the stuff that, you know, we've had over the past, our traditional, our 66, and a good representation of our stuff.
What do you think of some of these bikes in the show today, man?
Incredible bike. Old school, you know me, I love old school, and I'm glad everybody go back to old school. Okay, you watch Bob Ride, be cool, man.
The last thing that you deserve, gratuitous violence is the purpose I will serve.
Thursday night, April 29th, from 9 p.m. to midnight at the Barn, at the Wicked Wheel, Born to Ride magazine proudly presents the world's only biker comedy hypnotist, Gary Michaels.
Get on your bikes and ride!
With very special guests, Kevin Jacobs, with Anna Portaluppi. Thursday night, April 29th, from 9 p.m. to midnight at the Barn, at the Wicked Wheel. Panama City Beach Bike Week will never be the same.
Oh, yes, folks. Welcome to Born to Ride Live. I'm the Flash Man. That young lad over there, of course, Dave Nichols. Yes, indeed. Always exciting times hanging out with Dave.
Absolutely. We're glad you're here with us once again this week. And of course, we're tipping our hat to Willie.
Yep.
From Tropical Tattoo down there in beautiful Daytona Beach, Florida.
Yes, sir.
And, you know, he was hit by a drunk driver on his motorcycle. He's in the hospital ICU right now. And you can help. You can help wonderful Willie. Just go to the, if you would like to, you can go to Born to Ride Facebook page and you'll see the link right there for his GoFundMe page. So you can do a little GoFundMe, put a little cash in there to help him get through this this tough time of a guy who has given back to the industry so much over the years. And you'll be seeing more of his tropical ride-in chopper show that he does in Daytona every week in our next segment.
Without a doubt. And, you know, you and I talked about it last week when we found out all of the when it actually happened last week. And what a force this guy was in Daytona. You were talking last week how, you know, you don't really go to the strip and you don't go to the big commercialized bike shows. Everybody went to his.
Everybody went to his. There was only one great custom bike show before Willie started his, and that was out at the Last Resort. Al Bulling would put on this show out there, and it was just a ride-in chopper show, old pan heads and leaky shovel heads and the stuff you really would want to see instead of, you know, going to Harley. Always would have the bikes that looked like Easter eggs, every color you could imagine, you know. But Al put on a hell of a show. And then Willie, Al stopped doing his chopper show. And there was a need, man. There was a need for a ride-in old-school chopper show right there in the parking lot in Daytona there at Tropical Tattoo. So
you hit it on the head, too. It's about the old school, you know, about the old school things, man. It kind of reminded me of how, looking at some of the footage, it kind of reminded me how the feel of Choppertown down in Sarasota a couple of months back.
And see, that's the thing. That's what people want. That's the heart and soul and guts of it all that keeps this crazy thing going, man. I'll tell you. And, you know, speaking of that, we've got a lot more video and TV stuff that you can watch from 25 years of Born to Ride on our YouTube channel. So don't forget that. Yeah, wow, that was cool how you did that.
And you can check it out, too. borntoride.com has 25 years of the greatest biker content on the web. You need to go there.
You really do.
You need to go there.
Well, let's get into this next block. You're going to see all kinds of cool stuff coming up. We got Trace Atkins talking about the High Seas Rally, the only biker cruise in the world.
That's going to be on us before you know it, folks.
It's going to be all of us, And then we're going to the Born to Ride Vault, which shows all this great old classic footage of Willie's Tropical Tattoo bike show. You're going to see that coming up right now.
Race fans, Saturday, May 8th, RPM Promotions presents Edge of Summer, Power Elite, and Super Hooligan Pro-Am and Motorcycle Quad Flat Track Racing. Super Hooligan Nationals, Lima, Ohio, half mile at the Allen County Fairgrounds. $7,500 purse, fun for the whole family. Gates open 11 a.m. till miss blasts from the past. Brought to you by Super Plumber, Rubenstein Law, and Born to Ride TV and Magazine, as seen on Choppertown. Be a part of history, Sunday, May 8th. More info, call the number on the screen. Race fans.
Hey, y'all, it's Trace Atkins. One reason I'm excited about the High Seas Rally is their commitment to supporting our military and first responders. I'm proud to be helping High Seas Rally's Salute to Service mission, raising money for Wounded Warrior Project, and celebrating our heroes on the front lines. I'll see you in October 2021.
Hey, that's the deal. I was born to
we'll be right back.
bike show.
Oh, this is awesome, man. Hanging out with the boys, drinking some beer, having fun, and really seeing some really cool bikes this year.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff here. Speaking of bikes, man, tell me about this one you built.
Oh, it's my new, it's a personal bike. Just got the feeling to do something a little bit more old school. It's got a copper-coated rigid frame, and the brakes are copper. A lot of the motor covers and this stuff's copper. But the really trick thing about the bike is the carburetors. It's a triple Stromberg 97 carburetor setup. It's just really cool to ride. A lot of fun. Just have a good time, man. Daytona Bike Week rules.
It might seem good to me to let it in this way. You might be stopping me to forget the things you say. But this can't be let go, it'll never be the same. I thought it wrong this time, it just might have changed. But I know now that I've seen through the lies. Set in stone, set in stone, set in stone.
Steven Tyler from Aerosmith, you're watching Born to Ride TV. Oh yeah.
Hey, Jerry Motorman Palladino here for Born to Ride TV with my tip of the week. Here's an easy way to practice your U-turns and your quick left to right transitions all in one without even setting up any cones, simply using the parking spaces as a guide. What I'm gonna do is pull up here, make a U-turn, try to make it within the two spaces, and go back and forth. That's your quick left to right transition. That's the exact maneuver you're gonna need out there for car turns left in front of you. You're gonna have to be able to weave around them. Remember, all it takes to ride like a pro is a little practice. Perfect practice makes perfect. For more tips, tricks, and techniques, log on to www.ridelikeapro.com.
Sunday, April 25th, 12 p.m. at Papa Beer, Bar and Grill, Born to Ride Mega Bash. It's the Shallow Wrestling Championships and Snazzy Suds, the hottest bikini bike wash girls ever. Born to Ride TV taping and magazine shoot. Born to Ride Bike Show. Featuring live in concert, Tommy Rocks, the ultimate Southern Rock tribute show. Vendors welcome. Call now. It's all brought to you by Rubenstein Law. Representing riders since 1988. Think motorcycles. That's Papa Bear Bar and Grill Tampa. Don't miss it. Be there.
Dukes Productions presents the first annual Central Florida Cannabis Festival, coming April 24th and 25th to the grounds of the Plant City Farm and Flea Market. This is a two-day, family-friendly event with live bands, vendors, food vendors, and guest speaker seminars. This health and wellness event is focused on educating the community about the cannabis lifestyle. Bands include Monkey Bone, The Groove Diggers, Wendy Rich and the Soul Shakers, Ace Jackson and the Jump Kings, Piece of Woodstock, The Lint Rollers, The Greg Billings Band, the legendary Jim Stafford, and Nashville recording artist Bryce Malden. On Sunday from 10 to 4, it's the Born to Ride Ride-In Bike Show, sponsored by FTW. This is a free event. Just pay for parking. Proceeds from alcohol sales go to several Central Florida autism charities. The first annual Central Florida Cannabis Festival, April 24th and 25th, Sam Allen Road and Alexander Street in Plant City. For more information, visit centralflcannabisfest.com.
Oh, Dave, I know there was a lot of stuff going on there. Willie's tropical tattoos. We're going to see a little bit more from that. But did you catch the Papa Beer promo?
You know, it makes me want to pop a beer.
Yes. Jello wrestling.
Yep.
Bikini bike wash.
Yep.
The Born to Ride Bash is going to be huge, folks. You're not going to want to miss that. Put it on your day planner. Just mark the whole day off. Get out there early. Stay Late, live entertainment. Did I mention Jell-O wrestling? I don't know if I did or not.
You think that says
bikini bike wash? Don't know if I mentioned that or not, but it's happening. Pop a beer. That's a great place to hang out as we fellow bikers like to, well, you know, get together and do our thing, Dave.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You should probably go ahead and book your ticket and fly on in for that one.
Come on in for the old pop a beer, huh?
I'd do it. I would do it.
Well, let me tell you what we got coming up. Can I?
Tell me. Tell me, please.
We got like that damn Mayans thing again.
Yeah.
You know, the Mayans motorcycle thing.
I'm getting into that, Dave. I'm telling you, I'm getting into that.
Sons of arthritis. Yeah. Yes. More about that show. That's coming up. Plus the Crystal Harley-Davidson third annual Rosie Ride. We're going to talk about that a little bit. Mm-hmm. But as Flash was telling you, we've got more of Willie's Tropical Tattoo bike shows from years past and all of the amazing stuff that they've done. Every year, Mike Lichter would go out there and shoot all those bikes for us. And let me tell you, it's a fun time. Good people. And in addition to that, mm-hmm. we're going to have an interview with John Parham. Now, do you know who John Parham is, Flash?
John Parham was wasn't he the founder for J&P Cycles?
Exactly right. He and his wife, Jill, started J&P Cycles many years ago mm-hmm. out of Anamosa, Iowa. And these guys became huge.
Anamosa, huh?
Yes. Any kind of parts for your motorcycle, no matter what kind of bike you had, you could go to jnpcycles.com and get everything. And the cool deal was, if you had like an old 66 shovel head, you could type that in online mm-hmm. and it would tell you every single part. Like if you looked up a part, it would tell you if it would fit or not.
Oh, nice.
Amazing.
That's like, nice.
It was right. They were right. The thing is, it's like a good old school biker parts place, right?
I'll tell you, one of my favorite things to do when we go, every time we go to Daytona, is you got to roll into the big J&P right next to the Harley dealership out there. You got to do it. You have to do it.
Out in Sturgis, too.
As we say, you have to go in there and see what you just can't live without.
Yeah, yeah. And so J&P, a couple things spun off of John's love of motorcycles, because this guy figured out a way to make a living doing what he loved. He loved motorcycles more than anybody I've ever met.
Is that right?
John had the coolest collection of motorcycle toys you have ever seen. We did a whole article just on his toys.
Yeah.
Incredible stuff. Old antique motorcycles from this big to full size, you know.
And didn't you tell me he had a pretty different machine himself?
Oh, yeah. I mean, John collected bikes himself. Mm-hmm. He bought what was left of the Captain America bike from the film Easy Rider, the one that blows up. You know, the one that blows up at the end?
Right, right.
He bought the pieces. This is a crazy true story. He bought the pieces from Dan Haggerty, uh-huh. who is Grizzly Adams.
Right.
He's in the movie. He helped to build the bikes. He had something to do with helping to move the bikes around. And so John bought this like hunk of charred metal and he restored it. It was at the time the only existing Captain America bike that was really from parts of the original one.
No kidding.
The film, because the real two bikes that you see in the movie were stolen. Before the movie even came out, someone stole them out of Dennis Hopper's garage. And so, you know, they parted them out, had no idea what they had.
I did not know that.
Yeah. So the only real, true Captain America bike is the one in the National Motorcycle Museum in Anamosa, Iowa, that John Parham used to own.
Well, there you go, folks. If you ever, you know what? If you didn't want to go to Anamosa, now that gives you a whole new reason to go.
And there are hundreds and hundreds of antique, classic motorcycles, amazing stuff. Every marquee you can think of, and a few you can't.
Live without. There you go.
So yeah, that's the National Motorcycle Museum. You can look it up. I just did. It's nationalmcmuseum.org. I'll tell you all about it if next time you're in Anamosa.
There you go. The next time I'm strolling through, I am going to the J&P Motorcycle
it's
Museum.
It's fantastic. Right now. So you're going
to
meet.
Don't forget, 25 years of Born to Ride is all at your fingertips, borntoride.com. If perhaps you can't pick yourself up a paper copy of the latest Born to Ride magazine, you can thumb through it digitally right there online. 25 years worth of biker content, all right there at borntoride.com. Make sure that you do that, folks.
Don't forget the YouTube channel, our Born to Ride YouTube channel. We've got all kind of video for you to check out. And we've got a lot more show coming up for you, including that interview with John Parham, who is just the nicest, coolest guy you ever want to meet.
Get you choked up.
I know. Well, he passed away a few years ago. But we have at Born to Ride, we have the footage.
All right. Well, let's head into the Born to Ride vault now.
Hey fans, it's Angela Rain here, and I am super excited to share with you all of the details about my band's return to stage since this whole COVID crisis has begun. On Sunday, May 30th, my full band will take the stage at Crystal Harley-Davidson in Homosassa, Florida for the third annual Rosie the Riveter Ride. Come join us and celebrate this icon of women's role in the American workforce. For those of you unfamiliar with the history of Rosie the Riveter, Rosie was the icon of the movement to bring women into the workforce while American servicemen and women served in World War II. This marked a major and permanent shift in women's place in the workforce. So thank you, Rosie. So, what can you expect on May 30th? In addition to my band rocking the stage for multiple sets, there will be a Rosie Ride, a biker show-off event for all of you ladies out there who want to show off your rides, and a Rosie look-alike contest. Finally, I and a few of my talented dancers will even be teaching a little bit of line dance instruction for one of my songs. You probably should know it. I Want to Ride the Bull. So, bring your Harleys, bring your friends and men. We want to see you there, too. We don't want you to miss this one. In addition to thanking Crystal Harley-Davidson, I'd like to thank Born to Ride and Stilettos on Steel for all of their support of this very incredible event. And I hope to see you there on Sunday, May 30th, at Crystal Harley-Davidson in Homosassa, Florida.
From Horseback Street Choppers. I'm the chief editor, director, owner. So it's fantastic. Every year they have bikes that are unbelievable. They delivered once again some of the best bikes I've ever seen since the Smokeout are right here. They're all great. I mean, you had some close to rat bikes, you had some higher class bikes, but these guys are really talented. Put the bike together, they're fantastic. Because these bikes, there's more passion, more build, more energy and heart in these bikes than anything you see on the street that are put together with all that bling and all. These are some really good bikes. Well, that's how I feel with the magazine. The magazine's here to serve you, not the other way around. So to me, it's an honor to be here, to be invited, and to help bring all these people together in one location and to report it. I mean, it's really overwhelming. You know, these guys, they don't have a lot of money. They're not rich people. They're just the average Joe who wants to build a bike and want people to see what they did, share the knowledge, share the experience, the brotherhood. And they do it here. They bring it over here, and you see that camaraderie, and it works well to get together. It's a fantastic affair.
It was awesome, man. It was just like off the wall, and I want to thank everybody that comes out and supports this show. You know, it's not about any one thing, but it's about all the people and stuff that's involved. And a big cause, helping the vets and stuff, but we're really proud to be part of it. And all I can say is God bless America and God bless our troops. Every one of them, man. But today we raised enough money to get one of them a leg. And some of the money goes to the home out there and takes care of them and stuff. And we do stuff all year long with them and stuff. Nikki Lynn and the Arnie Foundation have always been big on helping the vets and stuff and the community and animal rescue and stuff like this. But this year, everything went to the vets. You know, we can't do no better than trying to take care of the people that have taken care of America and keep us free. Yeah, you know, it shows that there is some patriotism and stuff. And it seems like the biker community is one of the big groups that really care about our country. All I got to say, Ron, is God bless America, God bless our troops. And when you see a vet sitting there somewhere and needs a hand and stuff, man, lend that hand to him. You know, if you see somebody hungry, go ahead and feed him if you can, you know? And, you know, I want to thank you, Ron, for coming over and covering the show. Like I said, it means a lot. And I want to thank all the people that come out and participate, support the show. And if it wasn't for all the people that participate and help and stuff, you know, this thing would just go away, you know. And that's it's a big community effort. Get a new tattoo, come into a real tattoo studio, stay out of tents and trailers, and take care of your mom and dad. Born to Ride, 2013.
Time to get noticed with Media Design Shop. Web design, management and hosting, logo designs, marketing material, social media presence, video production, consulting, ad creations and more. Time to get noticed. Media Design Shop. Call now for a free consultation.
Turned out great. That old school chopper show. This year, we had a bunch of people help out with it. The Horse Magazine was over here, Cyclosaurus, Lead Sled, Sucker Punch Sally, and it was a good turnout. It really was. Everything was dead all over town, but everybody was pretty amazed at what a large crowd we brought in for the chopper show. And you need to come here and get some ink. The guys are working hard all week long. It's been kind of slow this year, like everybody, but it's a good place to come in and get some ink done.
'62 Panhead, resurrected, has about 75 miles on it as of today. Had it for about 20 years. Awesome. It's still going.
What'd you win?
First place, Panhead Award. Tropical Tattoo.
All right. Awesome, man. Congratulations.
Thank you, man.
Cool.
Oh, yeah.
Tattoo Bike Show.
Now you can take Born to Ride everywhere and anywhere. The new Born to Ride mobile app is ready for you to download. There's more multimedia, more information, more Born to Ride like never before.
Motorcycle listings. Sell or find your next motorcycle at motolistings.com. Motorcycle listings at motolistings.com.
I'm Tabor Nash, you're watching Born to Ride.
Whoa! And we're gonna hang.
My father, John Parham, loved motorcycles. He loved them so much that he dropped out of community college after 1 year, started selling used Harley-Davidson parts at swap meets around the Midwest. While at a swap meet one day, he spotted a 1955 Harley-Davidson FLH with the iconic Panhead V-twin motor. This was the bike of my dad's dreams. It was love at first sight. To my dad, the 1955 Panhead was more than just a motorcycle. It was a symbol for the vision of the new company, J&P Cycles. The bike was 24 years old in 1979. The seller wanted $2,500, which was more than what my dad had at the time. Later on, he received a tax refund check and spent it all to get that Panhead. The first thing he did was restore it to the original yellow color, the same yellow he used when he made the original J&P Cycles logo. The business was growing, but money was always tight. Then one day in 1991, J&P Cycles was on the brink of bankruptcy, and my dad faced the hard decision to sell the bike in order to pay payroll with J&P Cycles staff. He had no choice and sold the bike of his dreams. It was several years later when John Parham found the original Panhead and bought it back. The owner painted it, and so my dad had to restore the bike back again to yellow. I remember the yellow Panhead like it was a member of our family. Heck, even the first bike my dad ever bought me was the same yellow color of his favorite bike. Every motorcycle enthusiast remembers the first bike they fell in love with, the bike they learned to ride on, the first bike they ever owned, the first bike they restored, and for some of us, the bike that got away. For J&P Cycles, the 1955 FLH is a symbol of all these love stories between motorcyclist and machine. For us, the yellow Panhead is the story of J&P Cycles. Ask anyone who works at J&P Cycles, and they can tell you the story of the yellow Panhead. It's a symbol of the passion that our customers and our employees feel for riding.
Of everything that a land rally has to offer.
Go check out highseasrally.com. We'll see you there.
Oh yeah, baby!
What a show!
Goodness,
the time! What a show!
I'm telling you, it has just flown by once again. Hey, I just got a breaking news alert from Ron Galletti. The Great American Moto Fest will be returning to Boss Hogg's Ranch on July 24th.
That's right. We're talking about the return of the Great American Biker Rodeo. You like motorcycles? You like rodeos? Mm-hmm. Put them together.
Yeah.
Look out.
There you go. Boss Hogs Ranch. Put that on your day planner as well. Just schedule the date in. Mark the day off to hang out with us at Born to Ride. More to come on that, I'm sure, in next week's show and on Thursday night show, Boss Hog Radio,
July 24th.
Here on this Facebook channel. So make July sure you 24th. Check yeah, July 24th. Big Dave, I'll see you next week. That's all the time we have for tonight.
All right. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you next week.
Have a great week, everybody.
The Hog Stars are working hard to get you the most for your trade.
I'm hoping to trade in my old motorcycle, and I really hope to get $3,000 for it.
Hey, sir, I'm Bo, general manager here at Crystal Harley. I just got back from appraising your motorcycle, and the book says it's worth $2,800. But here at Crystal, we're prepared to offer you 25% more. How's $3,500?
Sounds awesome. Let's do it.
Absolutely.
Come see the Hog Stars at Crystal Harley-Davidson, where you'll get up to 25% more on your trade-in.
Check out the all-new borntoride.com with radio, TV, industry, adventure, events, magazine, social media, and much more. It's the all-new borntoride.com.